afternoon. My name is Anthony Vivolo, and I will be presenting TornyTrade.com. Before we get into TornyTrade, the problem is that there's a lack of financial education on all levels, leading to lack of financial knowledge, leaving people in the dark regarding what's happening in our economy. So what's the solution to enhance financial education? I believe that is TornyTrade.com. TornyTrade's unique platform offers the user a hands-on financial educational experience, allowing the user to gain invaluable market experience while fine-tuning their investment skills, plus offering the additional incentive of real financial gains. And this is all for free to the user. And now we're going to get a little bit into the business concept. Myself, Anthony Vivolo, I'm the active owner and CEO in the financial education industry. So now we're going to go through TornyTrade.com. This is our homepage. This is when you go on TornyTrade, this is what you see before you join, but for our sake, you're going to join as a member. This is our members' login page, where you see we have market data, trending stock prices, our top players, and financial news, streaming.
I'm not in trouble hearing you.
That's okay.
A quick question.
Yes.
What does Torny Trade mean?
Tournament trading. Stock trading.
What is it?
Tournaments. We're in.
Tournament trading.
Yeah. Okay, so anyway, we have market data, streaming stock prices, financial news streaming in from all the major financial news networks, but we can't have the trade, so how do we do this? We're going to go to our tournament lobby, if you look up at the top, which will show you the different variety of tournaments that we offer, ranging from single-day tournaments to annual tournaments to speed tournaments, which would be as short as 1 hour long, which would appeal to day traders and more advanced investors. And all these tournaments are going to vary in the number of entrants, from heads up, one-on-one investing, to tournaments with upwards of thousands of people in them. So to join a tournament, we'd simply go to the category single day for demonstration purposes. And these are the available tournaments. So to join, it's pretty simple. We just simply click join. Now we're in the tournament, and we want to start trading. So before we start trading, we have to look up stocks. We simply go to our lookup tab at the top, press it, and it would take us to our lookup page. We've also implemented Torny tips. We have 100 Torny tips throughout the whole website, attributing to the financial education aspect of the website. But if you see Google's type in, so we type in Google and search it, and we would get our basic market data for Google, including some advanced charts. So we see Google's trading at 702 share. Looks like a good time to buy. If we want to buy it, we simply have to select trade. Which brings us to our basic Torny trade platform, which I wanted to keep simple for new investors, but advanced to the point where experienced investors could use all the features that they've grown accustomed to in investing. So for our purposes, if we wanted to buy Google right now, we'd simply press buy. We could buy by the amount of shares or the amount of our portfolio. For this specific tournament, we have $100,000 in our portfolio. So to buy the 10,000, select buy, amount 10,000, place order. So the last zero got cut off, but we just bought $10,000 worth of Google, and now we want to see the place we're in the tournament.
So I'm sorry, everybody starts with a fixed amount of money.
Yes.
And then it's basically simulated buying and trading.
Simulated using the real-time market prices. So we're actually trading the stocks. Okay, so now we want to see what place we're in the tournament. We would simply go to our tournament standings page, where we are right now in 12th place, projected to finish in 4th.
And this is a national, open nationally?
Right now.
Kind of on your friends, or?
Right now, nationally, it's to the general public. Mm-hmm. So that's a basic overview of how the website actually functions. And getting into some competition, the three on top are all paper trading simulations. The bottom three, Scottrade, E-Trade, TD Ameritrade, are all online brokerage houses. And the stock market game in the middle is simulated stock trading, specifically geared towards high schools and colleges. And what Torny Trade is going to do is bring the three industries together. So the simulation aspect of the simulations, the educational aspect of the stock market game, and the potential to see real financial gains.
How will that work?
I'm going to get into that.
But how does the stock market game work? Is it basically
the stock market game, it's basically a simulation for colleges, high schools, for the classes, and they go on and they trade stocks.
What makes it?
It's just because for that specific company, that's their target market. They only sell to educational institutions.
And what's your target market?
Our target market, students, young professionals, and new investors, specifically between the ages of 18 and 24 years old, male or female. And their profile, we have John and Jill. John just got his first job. He's looking to invest in the stock market, but doesn't know anything about the market, so he wants to get some knowledge before doing so. Jill's a college student who loves trading, but doesn't have enough money to start. And revenue, before I get started in this, I'm not saying that this is 25, 25, 25. Being that it's a prototype, I haven't got any revenues yet, so these are just the revenue streams. Advertising, obviously, from outside companies. Premier membership subscriptions, which would be advanced platforms that people could upgrade to for a low monthly fee, subscription fee.
And what would they get there that you wouldn't get through free model?
You saw the platform that I offered, the simple buy sell. This would be a more advanced platform that you would see on like a TD Ameritrade or on an online brokerage house. Customer acquisition fees for companies targeting 20 trade specific demographic for potential customers. And tournament sponsorship. So if you were wondering how we're actually going to put money into these tournaments to give out the cash prizes, it's a unique way of advertising. So companies could actually sponsor a tournament, have their name featured in the tournament, but the cost would be putting up the money.
So I'm advertising, you're talking about advertising on the website?
Outside companies advertising on tournament.
Okay, so like an AdSense or
something.
So yeah, they putting money out.
Exactly.
And then you said there's a financial a cash reward?
Yes.
To somebody?
So
what are the laws involved with that?
Okay, this was a big thing when I started with Torny Trade. And if you run the website as a lotto type format, so people aren't paying specifically to get in the tournament, people don't have to put up any money. All the cash prizes are given through the website.
And that's one option. Go back to that side. There's still customer acquisition. I'm still not sure. How is that different from sponsorship advertising? Are you
customer acquisition fees? Say TD Ameritrade wanted to get some of Torny Trade's clientele.
Uh-huh.
So they would essentially pay me for my list, and it would work off a commission base off of.
It's actually customer referral.
Customer referral.
Yeah.
Revenue.
So referral, so like affiliate rep. If one of your people on your list became a TD Ameritrade customer, is that what you're saying?
Yeah, I would get a commission.
You would get a commission as affiliate rep. Okay.
Okay, so now market implementation. Start with the end in mind. I wanted to create an appealing brand name, a functional prototype, and gain some market validation. But Torny Trade is a website, and I don't know how to build a website, so step one was to find a programmer to build that website for me. And I came into contact with Dot Matrix Design Group. You might recognize a few of the companies that they've worked with. They do everything from branding, building your website, and online advertising. So set up a meeting with Dot Matrix. This is kind of the evolution of TornyTrade.com. Our first meeting, this is what I went to them with. If you take notice of different name, different logo, and really just the PowerPoint that I put together to try and give them an idea. So we agreed that in 2 weeks we'd come back to have a semi-functional prototype and we would work on the brand name. So this is meeting two, my semi-functional prototype. Still not the look I'm going for. I need something stronger, more professional. Next meeting would be the presentation of the new look for the website, where they presented these looks. If you go to column one, row three, that's the look I chose. And at this point, we figured our next meeting would be for the final presentation of the current prototype. So the next month and a half to 2 months consisted of phone calls and constant emails leading until last week, December 12th, the completion of the prototype.
So how did you determine the spelling of Torny Trade? It's throwing me off.
Domain names that were available.
T-O-U-R-N-E-Y Trade was not available?
No. And it was smashable short.
I was torn.
market validation, there's really no science to this. I basically walk around my laptop, had people demo the prototype and fill out the survey. These are some of the results. I got 105 people to do the demo and fill out the survey for me, and these are some of the results. When rating Torny Trade on his overall user experience, the average score was 8.9, low being a 5, high obviously being a 10. Pretty surprising number. Out of 105 people, 47 of them actually have traded stocks before. And people who have participated in stock trading games or simulation, 39 out of 105, which I also thought was a pretty high number. And I asked to categorize Torny Trade as financial educational software or as a virtual stock trading simulation or game. And the results were 38 financial educational software, 37 stock trading game, and 30 both, which is a good number for me because those are both markets that I'm going for. And in the last one, when asking if they would participate in the free tournament, TornyTrade.com, we had 101 yeses and only 4 no's. And these are just some of the survey comments after asking to leave a brief comment at the bottom of the survey. Interesting idea. I'd never trade the stocks and be afraid to with my own money, but a platform like this might give me the confidence to try it. So,
yes, yeah, I have a question. You have a quote there talks about promoting literacy, which I remember you said was a goal you had as well for the site. I'm trying to understand it. How does this promote financial literacy? Do you have a lot of, are you including a lot of content that explains people what are stocks, how you should diversify, or what is it?
Well, from square one, the home page of the website, you're having financial news streamed in just to gain awareness of what's going on overall in the economy. All aspects of the website, if you want to know what something means, you simply scroll over it and you get a brief explanation of what that is.
Got it.
So, and then the Torny tips implemented throughout the whole website are all information about, you know, diversifying your portfolio and trading information. Okay, so survey analysis, after analyzing all the data, most of the people that I surveyed after interacting with them all said that they would participate in Torny Trade tournaments, which left me with the overall consensus that we need to implement something like this in schools. So, but for the future of Torny Trade, I'll continue to progress and advertise to the general public, hopefully in the near future, being able to implement this in schools and high schools.